Are you currently suffering from pain deep in your buttocks over your sit bone that's made worse with activities such as prolonged sitting or sprinting? Hey everyone, this is Dr. Zach Green here, Performance Sport and Spine, and today's video we're discussing hamstring tendinitis, where it attaches to your pelvis. So the hamstring is comprised of four separate muscles, and it originates or attaches at the pelvis and then inserts on the lower leg of the tibia and the fibula. So if you think of this blue band as a hamstring tendon and this ischial tuberosity or the sit bones where it attaches, the problem or pain of sight is right where these two structures attach, called insertional tendinopathy, and this will be relevant later with the posture modifications and exercises. What does this condition feel like? Well, it typically presents as deep, localized buttock pain at the ischial tuberosity, and it's often long-lasting, and it limits things like sporting events and daily function. More specifically, it's worse with activities such as running, lunging, sprinting, or squatting, and it's usually not painful with things like walking, standing, or laying. Sitting via direct compression of the irritated tendon will cause pain, especially on hard surfaces, and also driving cars is often problematic. And then usually this pain gets a little better as you warm up, but if you push too hard, you'll pay for it the next day or after 24 hours. And then the pain should be reproduced if you stretch the hamstring or load the hamstring. What causes this condition? Well, it's a multifactorial issue, but the largest driver is increasing volume and or intensity rapidly or suddenly. So think overuse of a mechanical nature. And then there can be acute or chronic. So think acute is a rapid onset of days or weeks. So think you just started a sprinting drill in the last 7 days, or it can be chronic where there's this episodic buildup and eventually you feel pain, but it's been building up for a long time. Risk factors: genetics, older age, elevated BMI, metabolic issues such as diabetes, hormonal changes, and antibiotics, most specifically fluoroquinolones. If you please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and then don't forget to turn on notifications. Now we're going to talk about some activity and posture modifications to help calm that tendon down. First off, we've got to get that tendon to calm down, especially in the acute setting, think days and weeks. So let's say sprinting is a provocative activity, we got to cut it down. Usually 50% is a good place to start, and this is vital. If sitting is problematic, a couple options you can do is put a cushion under the opposite buttock so there's a space between the irritated tendon and the surface, avoid sitting on hard chairs, or have a higher chair, which puts your hip into less flexion, which will put less compression on the irritated tendon. It's best to temporarily avoid stretching, especially high intensity, and it also probably will be helpful to avoid deep squats or lunges. So it's important to note that as I raise my leg up or flex it, that tendon that's irritated gets compressed against the ischial tuberosity, and that can cause more pain. So it's best to find activities and positions that don't raise your leg as much initially to strengthen it without compressing it as much. Now we're going to go over the exercise and rehab portion of this video. Level 1 isometrics, hamstring bridge. On your back with 1 foot up, raise up and work up to 5 sets of 30 to 45 seconds. With 1 minute rest between sets, and your pain should be 3 out of 10 or less. Initially, if this is too irritating, you can do a double leg version and then progress to the single leg version. But when doing this, keep your hip only bent to 20-30 degrees to reduce that compression force that we talked about earlier. Level 2 is isotonic, so moving at a constant speed. So in a single leg bridge, we're gonna go up 3 seconds, pause, and then down 3 seconds. We're gonna start from 3 to 4 sets of 15 reps, and then over time progress to 8 reps. Rest 1 to 2 minutes between sets. Another option is a prone hamstring curl. So laying face down with an ankle weight or a machine, raise your leg up for 3 seconds, pause for 1 second, and return to the starting position over 3 seconds. The same sets and reps apply. So level 3 is putting the hip more into flexion or raising it up. Lunge. In a standing position, press 1 leg forward and lunge down to tolerance. Return to the starting position and repeat on the opposite side. The same sets and reps apply as the previous exercise, and increase difficulty, add weight. Romanian deadlift or straight leg deadlift. With a light weight with your legs straight, push your hips back and slowly lower the weight down 3 seconds, pause, and return to the starting position. Increase weight over time to increase difficulty. Single leg deadlift. Hold a light weight and the same leg of the hand holding weight, push backwards as far as you can for 3 seconds, pause, and return to the starting position in 3 seconds. Make sure to push your hip back so you feel tension in your glutes or your hips, and don't lean forward, which will cause tension in your back. Level 4, energy storage loading, or ballistically loading the tendon to prepare it for the demands of life. So the first one would be bounding, Another option is alternate leg split squats. The third option is kettlebell swings. And then the last option is sprinter curl with a band. With tendon rehab, some discomfort's the norm, not the exception. So a good parameter is if your pain is 0 to 3 out of 10 on that oral pain scale, it's probably safe. And it may even be a little worse within a few hours afterwards, but it should be calmed down within 24 hours. And then a great way to track your progress is self-monitoring through a short level or long level bridge, where you do a single leg bridge one time every day at the same time and then track your pain. So if your pain is getting worse over time, you can try to modify. Thank you for watching our video on proximal hamstring tendinopathy. This should give you all the tools to help manage it on your own. If you did find this video helpful, please like our video and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to check out our other videos.